Pseudoscience is really what sounds sort of sciencey and sounds kind of plausible, can be convincing, but when you really dive deep into it, there's no scientific evidence to back it up. Now, this is often used by people who are willing to take your money, willing to take you on a ride.
One of the things you see when people enter into the autism world, just like I did myself 17 years ago when my child was diagnosed, even as a doctor, you enter this world and you are suddenly put upon with so much information, so many messages, and it's really confronting and almost overwhelming to know, well, which one do I listen to? And I see this happen time and time again. People get bamboozled. And they're actually, at that moment, they can be a little bit vulnerable as well, because they might want to listen to messages that are easier to listen to, that offer more hope. But you don't want that message to have false hope.
I think you hear this phrase a lot, autism's a quack magnet. And really that's because what we call autism is almost an unknown. These are many, many conditions. I think families want answers, and when we can't give them very clear answers about, when we say things like, well, we need to look at your child's strengths and challenges and then determine from that what your child needs, I think that leaves room for different people to come in and say, what your child needs is this, or what your child needs is that.
Unfortunately, it can be very difficult to identify pseudoscience. It can sound very convincing. This is very easy to get past the layperson, somebody who's not educated in medicine. But when you've got a doctor like myself who's looking at the information or hearing it online, it is very, very obvious to us that they're using very strange language that's unscientific. So often you do need to check in with your own GP or your pediatrician, your specialist, and make sure that you are heading in the right direction.
It can be very easy to be lured into false information and to resist that temptation, which can sometimes be a very strong temptation. Because if someone's saying to you, XYZ works for you or for your child for a certain situation, that can be really tempting. So having that rigor of science is really critical to be achieving the best outcome.
Plenty of pseudoscientific treatments are actually harmful to your children. So there are many needles, infusions, glasses, weird therapy sessions that end up taking up a lot of your time and your child's time and don't do any good. So you've got to be really careful that you're not following down a very strange pathway, because you could actually be doing your child a lot of harm.
Lots and lots of advice. There is an enormous amount of advice out there that is just simply not correct. And sifting through that can be really, really difficult. And I think I find it very difficult for parents to know, well, I'm getting 50 messages. How do I know which one's right?
With autism, there are a broad range of different treatments that can be helpful, but there are also some treatments that there's no evidence to back it up. So certainly the common things we find are particular diets, elimination diets, dietary supplements, and even things like traveling overseas and having stem cell therapy. These really aren't proven. They can be very expensive and can do a lot of harm. When it comes to autism and vaccinations, the jury is back and they're talking and they've said that there's no problems with it. So we've been looking at this for many, many decades, and we haven't found any increased risk of having autism after having a vaccination.
Because what science does is it looks at what works and what doesn't, and it does so in a methodical manner that takes out things like bias out of the equation. Now, that's really hard to do, and so you have to be very rigorous, you have to be really disciplined and say, this is allowed information, this is not allowed information, because of all those biases.
And what we do find is that parents can often get very desperate, and this makes you very susceptible and vulnerable to people taking advantage of you. So you need to be really careful of this and only spend your money when it's going to be valuable for you and your family.
Everything we know, everything we do every day is based on science. When you put a toothbrush into your mouth, the shape of that toothbrush is informed by science. The toothpaste you put on that brush is informed by science. So why wouldn't the work you're doing with your child be informed by science? I think that's a simple question to ask. Where is your evidence? And we need to empower families to do that.
You've got to be really, really careful, because there are plenty of tricksters out there.